preparation, and then we're going to introduce the team to you. Sandy and I flew out of Orlando directly into that Cancun area, and as you approach Cancun, the American Cancun, it's absolutely beautiful. There's no place like it. But I will tell you that the 2 hour drive into Cancun Hilton to our Hyatt Hotel, okay, was rather interesting. And of course, the room was, well, beyond belief. This is the VIP room.
The unsurmountable amount of fulfillment, spiritual fulfillment that I came out of this trip. I will certainly keep going as much as I can, as long as the Lord permits me to do so. At least I have planned once a year. I'm going to make it my business to continue doing this. Thank you.
Vivian actually handled the evangelism part of the eyeglass clinic. So before they got their glasses, she was actually able to present the gospel one-on-one with people. So we were very blessed to have her. Our next speaker, and by the way, while we were there, at one point I had to keep saying, you know, drink your water, drink your water, drink your water. And Mel asked me how much Arlene paid me to nag him. So next up, I would like to introduce you to Sharon Bolt. Sharon works for a pregnancy center as well. She works for the Sanford Crisis Pregnancy Center in Oviedo, Florida. And she actually worked in the optician portion where she actually got to see people receive visual sight after they received spiritual sight. So.
Mingling with the people and loving, just, I was just, it was a blast. cute girl. I'm going to find some cute little glasses for her. So there were these little leopard print, and they were beautiful. Next to her, maybe was her papa, I don't know. And he was looking down too with glasses. And they were reading the newspaper. So I was like, yay, God. God, again, didn't have to let me see that. I would have been blessed beyond measure anyway. But he did. What a blessing. What a blessing. So I want to read the scripture again to you and just praise God for it. May I have the power to grasp how wide and long and high and deep is the love of Christ, and to know this love that surpasses knowledge, my understanding, that I may be filled with the measure of all the fullness of God. And boy, did I. So I want to leave you with this, and I love this because everyone I got to say this, I was learning it. So Sandy, please go ahead. Well, no, don't, because I lie. Anyways, I'm going to leave with you, and I'm going to say, Dios te bendiga, which means God bless you.
Our next two people would be Tim and Timothy, who went on the trip. And we had this trip starting at age 9, which is my son, up to age 82. So if you think, and Brother Arthur, I wish he was here today because he shared so much with our team and blessed us in such a way that was just amazing. And Melissa told me, she said, you know, Karen, he's going to be so worth having on the team, and he is, and he's ready to go back again. So up next will be Tim and Timothy Downs. And Tim started out with as the doctor's assistant, and then when Ron moved over to construction, he became the eye doctor. And then Timothy just basically did whatever I asked him to, really. He played with the kids, he helped with the flow of things, and just such a blessing. But they're gonna both share with you, so.
Hello, I'm Timothy Downs, I'm 13 years old. And this mission trip was definitely a blessing, and I'm really glad I went. I played with the kids, we did coloring, we origami, soccer, and some of them came every day and played with us, and the smiles on their faces was priceless. And one kid, he broke his toenail, well, didn't break it. He bent his toenail back one day and put a band-aid on it. And then the next day, he came back. It was still hurting, but he was still playing. So that's when I knew that they really wanted us to be there and enjoyed us being there. I also wanted to say that I'm allergic to peanuts. Peanuts, deathly allergic. And I can't really go on out-of-state mission trips because of that, because we don't know what food I'm eating. And so this mission trip was perfect because we knew exactly what was in the food, who was cooking it. And, and so I just wanted to say, if you have any allergies or anything that's stopping you from going, God's going to say to you, this is your mission trip. So if you hear him calling out, definitely go. And that's all I have to say.
Hi, my name is Tim. My wife and I, we all went, all four of my family, my daughter and my wife are sitting back here too. We had decided long ago that we'd never go on a foreign mission trip. We had no control of the food and allergy situations like the other kids. And when this one popped up, we knew this was one we were going on. But like she said, the doctor's assistant, were able to give 367 people who needed glasses the ability to see, to read God's word, to know what God has to say to them. And we gave them the gospel. Talk about giving them the love of God. We were there to do that, but we also left it there so they could read it for themselves. That was the beauty of this trip. Young and old, we had young ones, and generally the young ones just came by and wanted sunglasses. And that's fine, because she's right, the older they were, the more growth there was in their eyes, and they obviously all needed sunglasses. So we tried to give them all sunglasses. There was one boy who was 6. He was deaf, so he didn't know how to talk. His mother couldn't communicate with him, he didn't know any kind of sign language. The only thing we knew was that when he watched TV, he sat right next to it. So we got him from distance. So when we, but how do you choose? How do you tell him? Yeah, I had to talk in Spanish. He
explain to them, Clara, you know, mayor, your best, one little dose. So it's like go to the dentist, go to the doctor's office. They say, which one's clearer, one or a dose, first or two, second? It's the same thing, but how do you explain that to somebody who's deaf, can't talk to you, and wouldn't speak your language if he did? So trying to figure out how to communicate with this kid. Finally, we'd done it several times, and every time I put the glass in front of him, he was a thumbs up, he was happy. So no matter how strong the strength or how little the strength. So finally, I just pushed him over to him, and I put each one in his hand, and let him look. And finally, I just motioned to him, which one do you want? What do you like? He picked one up and said this one. I mean, it was all, there was no words. Communication was done by just motion and pointing, and mom talking to him, but he didn't hear anything mom said. So in the end, he walked out the class that he needed. God was there. He was there for the whole trip. From the beginning, we were under attack. I don't know if anything went off as planned in this whole trip. But God provided whatever we needed every time something came up. And the day before we left, I had a lot of things planned to do, but my truck died, my computer died. I mean, just under attack from the beginning. Van, I'm sure everybody's heard about the van breaking down on the way out. So taxis all week, no transportation. Rainstorms, you can't get dinner to us. The whole week was God just working around whatever was thrown at us. It was incredible. Thank you for your time.
And next up will actually be my family that went. That's my husband Ron and my son Justin. Being from the South, my husband thought it was really funny that the Spanish word for lady boss is jefa, because it sounds like heifer. And so he thought it was a great time to be able to call me that legitimately. So he thought that was really funny. He's like, oh no, I don't mean it. But my son did that in Costa Rica as well, my oldest son. So they thought this was really funny. But this is actually Ron and Justin's first trip as well. So I'm going to let them share with you what their experience was.
So Pastor Mellon, I have a bet that if he speaks, I will buy his lunch.
Speak.
So this is Justin. Are you going to speak? My name is Ron. Looks like I'm getting lunch today. This was my first mission trip, and it's actually because of this young man right here that I went on my mission trip because he twisted my arm out of guilt to make me go. We had been watching a cartoon on TV and told my dad you need to go. So that's really what propelled me to go. Crazy busy. And he also worked physically hard out there helping to build the parsonage, is what I would call it, the home for Sandy's mom and dad. And he labored manually day in and day out, but then would get up and show his heart. So I was very touched by Mel's contribution and hard work. And also my wife. I have to say that. That she, everybody knows that there's a lot of work that goes on the mission trip, but there's a ton of work that goes on behind the scenes to get everything organized. And everybody has issues that they have to be dealt with, and lost passports, misplaced passports, documentation, the list is just endless. And she worked very hard on the trip, but also worked exceedingly hard as well. So I was touched not only by the trip, but more so by the people that I was doing on the trip. So that's what it's about.
Justin, we're proud of you.
That's very introverted, so that's God. You know, he pulls us out of our comfort zones, doesn't he? Continues to grow us always. And last up will be Mr. Jim Gainey, who is Melissa Hyland's dad. And he wants to share a few minutes about his experience. Now, he has been on other trips, which is unlike most of the team. Most of the team, this was their first trip. So he would like to share a little bit with you as well.
Hi, I'm Jim Gainey. I was on the trip, of course. And just a couple of thoughts I thought you might be interested in. Sort of an overview and also what we were doing here. When you think of building a church here, you think of going out and talking to people, being friendly when they come in the door, getting to know them, inviting them to church. When you're building a church in Mexico, it is hard physical labor. And I saw most of that. They didn't ask me to help. I was a little over the average age, and I didn't help much with that. Hard physical labor. Your pastor, Sammy, they must have carried thousands of pounds of cement and concrete blocks and rocks. Now, the church is built. They were building a home to go beside it. But building a church in Mexico, is rural Mexico anyway, is not like building a church in America. They have to do everything we here do here, but then before that, they have to do all of that. And just a thought here, population there is a little questionable exactly what it was. Something I got from the internet was 7,000 population of the town. I don't think that's absolute. Paid their own work. Any money that we have that's in our organization that's given to us goes to other things than those trips. Everybody on that trip pays their own way, and everybody that comes that we come in contact with on any trip that we do gets the gospel message in their own language. And those are just a couple of things I wanted to mention. Thank you.
In your bulletin, if you will, you'll find an insert that I'd like you to take out. The Lord has led me.